Hi there, Doug Stuman with IT Creations with another Supermicro server. This time I have the Supermicro A+1114S-WN10RT server. If you watch some of our other Supermicro videos, then you know that the A+ squeezed in there, that this system supports an AMD EPYC processor. Just a single processor in this case, and up to 4 terabytes of memory at capacity. If you like our videos, hit that subscribe button, maybe even a thumbs up too. You can withhold those accolades until after the video to make a more qualified choice. Let's get to it. This is a business workhorse server with support for applications like for a network server, general file server, virtualization, and cloud computing. That said, with all flash NVMe drives up front, it offers low latency, fast access storage. At only 1U, it does have some fairly impressive credentials, but not the same density as, say, one of Supermicro's hyperservers or the Cloud DC lineup with dual sockets, lots of cores, twice the memory, and usually double-wide or single-wide GPU support. Those are also offered for data centers and the like, where space is a premium and you will pay for it. The A+1114S-WN10RT is part of Supermicro's WIO servers, that W for wide-ranging and the IO for input-output options. In other words, wide-ranging input-output options. It still gives you some impressive core counts with just one AMD EPYC CPU at up to 64 cores. It supports 10 hot swap U.2 NVMe 4 or NVMe 3 drives natively, but it can be outfitted with SAS or SATA as an option in those 10 front 2.5-inch storage bays. On the right of those drive bays is the power on button, unit ID button with integrated LED, two USB 3.0 ports below, and status LED lights above. On the back of the server, dual 750-watt platinum-level PSUs, a serial port, dedicated management IPMI LAN port, four USB 3.0 ports, which I might add is about two more than usual, then dual 10 gigabit Ethernet RJ45 ports and a VGA port. There is no room for an OCP card, but there are three PCI slots in back. I mean, it is only 1U. Are you interested in the Supermicro A+ Server 1114S-WN10RT? If you are, then for a limited time, you can save up to $500 off a system that's listed or one that you can configure using our online configurator that's listed at $5,000 or more. Just click that link to see more about this system, and when you're ready to make a purchase, just mention this video. The configurator is actually kind of cool. It gives you a running total of the cost based on the components you add to your configuration. It's like that guy at the drive-thru window, your favorite fast food place. Oh, you forgot to add fries? Ha, no problem. Inside the case, there are three PCI 4.0x16 slots for add-on cards. Add-on cards supported on this system include network interface controllers, you know, NICs, the I/O cards I was mentioning, and hard drive controllers if you want to add in SAS drives or want to have more control over your storage in general, with more RAID options. No mention is made for GPU support. You see that little module on the board? That's the ASSPEED AST2500 Baseboard Management Controller Module, or BMC. Access through that dedicated RJ45 IPMI LAN port on the back of the chassis. Administrators can access the system remotely using a standard browser interface. Supermicro does offer a few management options, including SuperDoctor 5, a Supermicro Update Manager, and an IPMI configuration utility. SuperDoctor 5 comes in local and remote management versions. It monitors the health of the system in real time and can provide alerts to administrators, among other things. This is for a single system or one-to-one. The IPMI configuration utility can be accessed out of band and is just that, a command line interface that is compatible with IPMI 1.5 or 2.0. Not mentioned in the documentation for this system is the one-to-many Supermicro server manager. I think this is a good place to move on. In addition to the upfront drive bays, there are two slots for disk-on module or DOM ports. The SATA DOM is a SATA 3 flash memory module. There are several uses for the SATA DOM, including use as a boot drive, backup recovery drive, or for operating system installation. Of course, you can also use the two PCI 4.0x2 slots on the system board right next to the DOM ports. Those are for support of M.2 storage devices, which can also be used for the same thing. I will mention there are thermal limitations on those M.2 drives. The processor supported on this system includes the 7002 and 7003 series AMD EPYC processors, including 7003 series processors with 3D V-Cache technology. 3D V-Cache enables up to 768 megabytes of L3 cache for better queuing at the CPU, lower latency, and enhanced power. In general, both the second generation Rome and third generation Milan CPUs provide up to 64 physical cores and 128 virtual threads. The thermal design power range, or TDP, is listed at 280 watts, which does include all CPUs in these categories. Choices, choices. With 16 memory module slots and a processor which supports 8 memory channel architecture, you can install one or two DIMMs per channel. That includes standard and 3DS load reduced or registered DDR4 DIMM modules. Memory speed is up to 3200 megahertz with certain configurations, but will reduce to either 2933 megahertz or 2666 megahertz at full capacity. Keeping it all cool is a bank of 6 4-centimeter fans. Designed for general networking applications, virtualization, and use as a cloud computing server, the 1U Supermicro A+ Server 1114S-WN10RT is ideal for small to medium-sized businesses and has the capacity to grow along with your business needs. With only a single AMD EPYC processor, you can deploy up to 4 terabytes of memory with support from 10 U.2 NVMe storage bays, or go SAS or SATA. Even at only 1U, it does have a lot to offer. If you like this video, think about subscribing as I will be reviewing more servers and professional workstations. If you are interested in this little gem, visit itcreations.com for more information using that link right there or the one in the description below. If you have some pressing questions, post them in the comments section below. Till next time, I'm Doug Stewart with IT Creations. Thanks for watching.